You know, Cindy, the issue here is that when we go from rain to freezing rain, you can't see it, you can't hear it, so you don't really know what's happening unless you're looking at that surface temperature. So looking even at your car temperature, that could be a little bit insightful. But if you do happen to hit ice on the roadways this morning, pump your brakes, do not slam them. That is critical because, of course, at that point, we're talking about sliding. Freezing rain can't be heard or seen. However, when we do eventually change over to sleet, you'll hear that difference. It makes a sound. The bouncing of the sleet off the ground, and it's more of a crunchy feel to it. So there will be a little bit more traction as we move into that transition for later this morning. Now let's talk about the concept of freezing rain. It's really rain that's falling down to the ground, and then cold air at the surface allows that rain to freeze over onto the trees and roadways. Now at this point, the amount of ice we're expecting, not going to be a huge concern for power outages, and that is some good news there. But there's enough ice in the forecast that we will see slick travel. Some of the tree limbs could be slightly coated, and something we're watching for the late morning. There is going to be likely a longer period of sleet for today. That works in our favor. This is something we're watching with above freezing temperatures just above the atmosphere moving toward the surface as a nice layer of cold air that allows us to actually hear and see that sleet falling. So it's not quite as treacherous for travel, but there is cold air beyond this, Cindy, so we're really not going to see much of a melting process.